There is no doubt that the health crisis, caused by the spread of this new illness, has become an economic crisis as well. As companies are shutting down and millions of people are affected by layoffs, governments all around the world are launching rescue packages in order to prevent an economic collapse. Trillions of dollars, euros, pounds and yens are injected into the economy, but the fact of the matter is that all this money, supporting businesses and households, will in most cases not even cut it. Moreover, it will push up budget deficits to new highs. The reasons behind this fact are pretty simple. The amount of stimulus in some countries are as high as 10 or even 20% of GDP, but according to experts, more money will be needed to support hardest hit companies and workers as well. If this was not enough, tax revenue is also on decline due to the fact that companies are forced to shut down and to lay off people. This raises deficit levels even higher. This video will cover consequences and examples throughout different countries, so make sure to watch till end, it should be interesting. Before we get into it, give it a thumbs up and push that subscribe button to support the channel. Without any further ado, let's jump into some interesting facts. In many developed economies, deficits are expected to rise by as much as 5 to 8%, including here the United Kingdom and Germany. France is already entering the greatest recession since the Second World War. The US, Italy and Canada are also expected to have high deficit. The US country to GDP ratio was already close to 80%, and the stimulus packages approved so far could push that ratio up to about 95%, or, if other relief package will be put in place, even over the previous record of 106%, set in 1946. In Britain, the government intends to auction £45 billion in government debt in April alone, and experts warn that the country is likely to come out of this crisis with government debt at more than 100% of GDP. These are just two examples, but we also have to acknowledge the fact that worldwide debt has never been higher, and this could have serious consequences throughout the coming years, because borrowing has become so rapid that it might become unsustainable. According to the Institute of International Finance, total worldwide debt, made up of borrowings from households, government and companies, reached $253 trillion already at the end of September 2019, before the lockdowns. That's almost $33,000 of debt for each people living on this planet. The hundreds of billions of dollars in stimulus packages will raise debts even higher. We all know what debt really means. Simply put, borrowing with interest. Problems start when borrowing is made in excess. In the case of emerging countries, borrowing money is more complicated, because while loans to developed countries are usually seen as safe investments, loans to emerging governments are considered riskier. That is why some of these countries will issue debt in a foreign currency, considered more stable. High debt, however, can be difficult to pay back, so the country may fall behind on its debt obligations and default. There are examples to this. It has happened to Russia in 1998 and Argentina in 2001. By the way, in the 80s, the world economy was entering a recession. In 1982, Mexico announced it cannot pay off its debts. This move started such a wave that almost 30 countries had to restructure their debts, 16 of them were in Latin America. We could continue with many such examples, the most recent being the 2008 financial crisis. Before this took place, there was a global debt crisis starting from 2002. Big banks made private sector borrowing easy, especially in Europe and Central Asia. The US mortgage system entered into collapse in the second half of 2007 and 2008. These shock waves hit the world, and economies around the globe went into recession. In the US, the economy sank to its lowest level since the Great Depression. This new debt crisis is thought to be the largest, fastest and most broad-based ever. The reason behind this fact is that it involves both public and private debt and is happening on a global level at the same time. Why is this dangerous? Because the more debt a country has, the more it has to spend to pay off that debt, leaving less money for other investments. For many countries, reducing debt could take up to several years or even decades. There are some examples in our history to explain this fact. During the Second World War, for example, Britain was running out of money and started borrowing more and more money. After the war ended, it took Britain about 61 years to pay off its debt. In 2001, as I mentioned earlier, Argentina was really struggling. The country's debt to GDP ratio reached almost 170%, which caused the country to default on over $100 billion worth of debt. Investors moved out the country, leaving millions of people in poverty. In 2012, Greece was almost in the same situation, then Venezuela accumulated huge debts by 2017. The US debt to GDP ratio before this health crisis was around 106%, Italy's was 133% and Japan's was 237%. Remember, before the lockdowns, when industries were still open and companies were paying employees. It is obvious that in order to save economies from collapse, more debt will be accumulated by countries. In the end, all these stimulus packages will have to be paid back, and since governments make money from taxes, in the end taxpayers will have to pay off these astounding debts. Since we're talking about a long-term period, future generations will feel the burden of these debts. There is at least one more problem though. Before this crisis began, households in the US had about $14 trillion worth of debt, the highest level in history. Student loans accounted for almost $1.6 trillion worth of household debt. Statistics show that the average household has about $100,000 worth of debt while having on average only $8,000 worth of savings. Considering all of these facts, the $1,200 stimulus checks won't really cut it, and the only way out of this debt crisis, which as we have seen it, is a global one, is to lift up the lockdowns. This might take some while though. Thanks for watching, stay safe and healthy, and make sure to subscribe.